So, at least to me, the winner to this beef is extremely obvious. If you can remove any biases that you have, whether it be a liking towards these two MCs or a hatred that you have towards these two MCs, if you remove all that and genuinely look at the two records that are in front of you, I think the winner to me is so obvious. And I've had my problems with the man that won this beef, and even though I've had a lot of criticisms for some of his recent output, to me the obvious clear winner here is still Eminem. So we can start from the beginning. M dropped Not a Like along with this Kamikaze album, which responded to some of the comments that MGK made a few years ago about Eminem's daughter Haley. And to me, this wasn't anything crazy, but as a diss track, I thought it was okay. I thought it was a good way to set up the beef, but I don't really think it fully nailed a mark, at least in my opinion. But I think it was at least a pretty good way to set up the beef for Eminem himself. MGK responded with his own diss track, Rap Devil, 3 days later. And a lot of people considered this move to be ballsy in the hands of MGK, and they felt like it took a lot of pride to respond to one of the GOATs in such a quick way, and I feel like there was a lot of hype towards the track. But to me, this was just good marketing in the hands of MGK. I think from his standpoint in the beef, there was nothing that he accomplished here except just using this entire beef to receive a little bit more fame. It really was just good marketing for MGK, and nothing else was accomplished. So Rap Devil starts off with the infamous, "Your beard is weird," and grab him some Clippers lines, which I think M used to his advantage. The entire beef is extremely petty. The reason why Eminem started it was petty. I think MGK's response and the fact that he jumped on this so quickly and even released a fucking EP right after just to keep capitalizing on his name, everything was so petty about this. Even the diss track, Rap Devil himself, is extremely corny and petty, and I feel like M, when it came to his response, he used that against him. And I'll get into that once I reflect on Eminem's response. So there's really some things that just truly pissed me off about this diss track. And one of those things is just how much MGK seems to be sucking off Eminem. I've never heard someone size up another MC that they're fucking beefing with. Not even a minute into the diss track, he says, "Homie, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive." Now, from MGK's point of view, I think it's smart for him to at least acknowledge the fact that Eminem's a legend and he'll never reach the status of Eminem. He'll never accomplish what he did. That's fine. Do that once throughout the diss track, at least so you can show to the audience that you're not in denial and that you really understand the situation at least. But this man does this 3 times throughout the track. So not only does he call him the greatest rapper alive, he also says, "They made a movie about you. You're in everybody's top 10. And he later goes on to say, "Yeah, I'll acknowledge you. You're the GOAT." I feel like you can get away with a lot of things in a diss track if the diss track is solid and it hits hard. But when you don't do that, there's a lot of things that just piss me off. And the fact that MGK literally called Eminem the greatest ever 3 times? Like, dude, this is a fucking diss track, and it sounds like you're literally sizing your opponent. If anything, I stepped away from Rap Devil just realizing how much more Eminem means to rap than MGK. And I took this from just listening to Rap Devil alone. So he continues on to try to capitalize on the age difference that there is between MGK and Eminem. And MGK says, "Let's talk about the fact that you blackballed a rapper that's twice as young as you." And he has a lot of these age lines sprinkled throughout this thing. I think Eminem responded to every single jab that MGK could have thrown at him very well. When it comes to Killshot, Eminem responded very well by saying, "I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you." And when you come off such a bad record like Rap Devil, and you listen to how Eminem responded to all these things, it really just seems like a reality check to everyone who could have thought that MGK was winning this. When Eminem is 80 and he's not making music anymore, I promise you that he's probably still going to be selling way more records than MGK when he was 20. And I don't think that you necessarily need to be the most popular or have the most accomplishments in order to win a beef. Well, look what happened with Pusha T and Drake. Pusha T obviously is never going to be selling as many records as Drake, but he came in with a plan, an overall strategy to how he was going to attack Drake. And it worked out so well, so it doesn't really matter if you come with all these bars about record sales and all that. Pusha T had an overall direction that he wanted that beef to go in, and he accomplished that. MGK came into this beef with one sole purpose: to capitalize on the fame and nothing else.
Now, people are saying that this whole thing is a ploy that Interscope's using to help you sell records.
Oh man, that'd be great. That'd be a big help.
He wouldn't care if he actually lost, because at least he got all the fame from it, from using Eminem. And I feel like when you do that and your record isn't good and the person that you're going with responds to every single jab in such a reality check type of manner, it makes you look foolish. He later goes on to say the big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Now this and the real Slim Shady can't stand up line were the only two lines that genuinely got me excited throughout the track. And I do think he's right here, MGK. I'll give him his props that I think Eminem's response to all this was very petty. He couldn't really take the joke, and I feel like that's something that Eminem did a lot back in his career. And the fact that he's responding this way to it could kind of make him seem a little bit hypocritical in a way. But besides that, there's nothing really here that stood out to me. But the one fucking thing about this record that really pissed me off was the entire "you should go back to recovery" line. So earlier in the diss track, he says, "your last four albums is as bad as your selfie." And later on, in an entire new verse, he says, "you should go back to recovery." And if you just do the simple fucking math, your last four albums are bad? That would include fucking recovery. And the fact that he completely forgot about that and said, "yeah, you should go back to recovery," means that we don't even know what the fuck MGK is saying here. We don't even know if he means the shit that he's writing down. And the fact that people genuinely believe that Rap Devil can be considered a track that wins a beef, it's just fucking ridiculous to me. And I think it shows a little bit of the Eminem bias that people have. I know it's a cool thing to hate Eminem now, and even though I've had my fair share of criticisms about him, put the bias aside, Eminem is a clear winner here. This might not be one of the worst diss tracks I've ever heard, but it is easily probably the laziest and most gimmicky record I've ever heard. To be honest, I don't think Eminem needed much to respond with in order to be declared the winner of this shit. Because when I look at how transparent the situation is with MGK and how weak his record is, there's no way that he can be solidified as the winner. And I do think there was a chance for both rappers to come off as losers here, but I do think M's record was pretty good, all in all. So Eminem starts with the Brianna line, which I think worked, and only because MGK's record and MGK's entire situation towards this beef was extremely corny and petty, and Eminem used that against him. Eminem even says in the beginning, "let's just see who can out-petty who," and even though the reasoning for this beef is so fucking shit, Eminem is the one that completely outsmarted the guy here. I think that bringing that viewpoint into the track is what made these quote-unquote corny lines like the Rihanna line work. He literally goes out to say, "insult me in a line, compliment me on the next." Damn, like even M knows that this man's literally just sizing him. If I was Eminem listening to the record, I'd be like, holy shit, this is like a huge fan of mine. I think the man bun line is one of those really corny lines, but word because of the situation of this beef, I genuinely think it worked. And even if you miss the entire hypocrisy about MGK's beef, Eminem literally lays it out here for you. "Yo, Slim, your last four albums suck. Go back to recovery." "Oh, shoot. That was three albums ago. Get your facts straight before you come at me, you little goof." Like, even Eminem laid it out for in front of you. This guy literally doesn't even believe what the fuck he's saying. And people still think that MGK even has a chance of winning this beef? Shooting a video just to dig your own grave. Yeah, like, the extent that MGK stretched this shit out, he shot a video for this, he released an EP fairly shortly after this. Even afterwards, he was just going online saying how, oh, he lost. He tried to tell an entire crowd that he won the beef, even though the entire crowd was booing at him. He stretched the situation so far. It looked so fucking corny from the outside. And it's literally just a man stretching an entire situation for him just to get a little bit more fame, and he's losing the entire time. It was so hard to watch. And I love when Eminem switched his flow a little bit. And again, the Eminem haters I know hated this part when he said, "your red sweater, your black leather, you dress better, I rap better." Is that a death threat or a love letter? Like, literally, is this just you kind of trying to hype me up a little bit, and you capitalize off my name and barely even throw shots at me because you don't even believe what the fuck you're saying? Like, this entire situation with MGK just solidified that he's like one of the corniest and wackest rappers to me. And another major fun part about this beef is the fact that the best line out of the entire beef wasn't even about the opponent. Eminem closed it out with the Diddy line, saying, "but this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills, but Kellis, the day you put out a hit's the day that Diddy admits that he put the hit out that got Pac killed." So even the best line, for the most part, had nothing to do with MGK. Holy fuck, that line was so fucking hard. And I love how he ends it, you know, referring back to the Marshall Mathers OP days, just saying, "I'm just kidding, Diddy, you know I love you." Like, I really think Eminem executed well here with what he had. And I think the fact that a line towards Diddy was the best line perfectly encapsulates his entire situation. Because how much do we really know about MGK? He had a big hit early in his career, but it was mainly because of Waka Flocka Flame, who just murdered him on his own track. And besides that, it's like, who the fuck keeps up with this guy? The fact that Eminem even wrote a diss track about this guy is super fucking impressive, because you can go at Eminem for so many things. He's been in the public eye for years now, We know so much about Eminem. What the fuck do we know about MGK? We don't know shit about this man. So again, to me, Rap Devil is so whack. And this entire situation is so whack towards MGK just because he had no business being here. It was so gimmicky. He didn't really have a goal out here except to just capitalize on the situation and nothing else. And also the Rap Devil diss didn't have any like details along with it. A lot of diss tracks have these details that go behind the title and behind the writing within the record that Rap Devil didn't have. When you look at Back to Back by Drake, which I think is a great fucking diss record, he included the baseball cover between Toronto and Philadelphia, and he released it on the same day that that occurred, and that's why it was called Back to Back, because they won back to back games to defeat Philadelphia in that series. I feel like that was a very juicy fact to include into this part. And with Killshot, Eminem did the same thing. Partly for why he named it Killshot was because MGK's name, Richard Colson Baker, was a reference to the movie itself and how a married couple, Wayne and Carmen Colson, were targeted by an experienced mafia hitman, Armin Dagas. That is a juicy fact that sort of adds to this Killshot record, and it makes you want to just go back to it. And MGK had none of that. To me, this was one of the most unprepared beefs ever. It really shows you how whack and transparent something can be if one is just jumping into a situation they're not ready for. And I think that has MGK written all over it here. But yeah, those are my thoughts on it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Please like, please subscribe, please share, and I'll be with y'all soon. All right? Peace.